So,
what do you think?
Well, it's weird. It doesn't feel the same as playing Metroid Prime 1 and 2. I think part of that, it isn't the holiday season, and those games are both holiday games. And, you know, when I was playing those games, I would constantly think to myself, wow, this is among the best looking game I've ever seen. Like, it's beautiful, stunning, and like, while playing this, that thought rarely crosses my mind.
So, like, I've gone up and down with this game. So, when I first turned it on, you know, you hear the music, the opening music, and like, I just got goosebumps.
The music is great as usual. I mean, same composer, this series always had good music. It doesn't look good. It looks fine. And like, it doesn't bother me. And at times it's beautifully done. But like, when those cutscenes happen, like whenever there's a cutscene where they have to show something really big happening, or they zoom out to show like something hitting a planet, or when you're flying through space, those look bad.
Okay.
Those really look bad.
Agreed. And anytime you see a person's face or the purple girl, like, you're like, oh my god, that looks terrible. But I disagree. Like, later on, the game actually does look good. Like, I was like, wow. I just, like, it's the same old feeling that I got in the other Metroid Primes where I just stop and, like, I look around.
Well,
and
I'm
like, so intricate, so,
like,
to, like,
the boss,
the artistry.
Like, the boss chambers are always really beautiful. When you're walking up, there's, like, you know, a way to walk up. And it's just, like, it's there to look pretty. And, like, good color usage, good lighting. But still, like, it's dealing with the limitations of the console.
Well, you start off in these spaceships, and they're all austere, just like sheet metal, you know, kind of boring. It's technological.
It looks like Halo, but not as good as Halo.
But as the game wears on, it's almost like they took the most boring looking areas and front loaded them. As the game goes on, I just slowly got more and more into it, and slowly started noticing things. And like, Skytown, which is the, like, there's several different planets in the game. Like, if you just look around, it gets more and more intricate, more and more detailed. Just like the level of attention in art direction, it's just unbelievable.
Right.
Like, if you look, like, there's like murals on the floor, and like,
I agree that level in particular does look really good. I mean, like, the artistry, the, you know, the aesthetics there. However, like, still the graphics themselves, like, you know, what's on the screen versus how good I think these games used to look. It just, it looks old. It looks like an old game. I mean, it looks like a really beautiful old game, like among the best looking of on the console.
Right. My roller coaster ride with this game has been hearing the opening music, seeing it, just like goosebumps, super excited, then starting to play it, and not only like the graphics are a little dull at first, but like the control, like, I started off with the standard speed control, and I'm just like, you're turning, and it's like, okay, I'm gonna turn left, like, take a drink, like, slowly, okay, you know, like, look around, read a magazine, like, then you're turned around. And I was like, jumping around, trying to get around, I wanted to plug in a GameCube controller again. Yeah, I was like, I wonder if it would take a GameCube controller, I wonder if I could do it.
I find that surprising. I started with advanced controls because I knew I wanted that control. I knew I didn't want to mess around with the other stuff. So,
you did advanced controls.
Yeah, I started from the outset with advanced controls, but there still is like an hour or two of like, this doesn't feel quite right. Like,
you're lucky that you started with advanced because there is that learning curve, but you have to go to advanced because the speed is much faster and it's harder to do when you're aiming at things, but it makes turning around and getting around so much better. And it was immediate relief. I mean, I was like, oh, this is how the game is meant to be played. I came in, I was just like bitching to Ryan. I was like, I don't know about this game, man. I think they screwed it up. I just want the old controls. But once you get them down, the old Metroid Prime games, I think what their weakness was is once you locked onto something, you just shot. There was no aiming.
Well, yeah.
And you can, that option exists in this game.
On the easy controls?
You turn auto lock on. And that option exists in this game. But the cool thing about this game is, even though you can lock your perspective, and that's necessary to lock your perspective, it still takes some skill in how you aim.
One of my problems is I think the combat is actually more fun, and I think it makes the game seem more action-packed. It makes it seem like you're not just jumping around and locking onto things, but enemies take so many shots. They really do. And powered up shots are almost useless because enemies are so fast, they're always dodging them. So for the first like 5 hours, I kept thinking I missed a gun. I'm like, how come every enemy takes like 20 shots?
You do get this kind of super gun, which the game expects you to use a lot. And when you turn that gun on, it is much more like the old enemies, but you're right. A lot of times, like,
are you talking about the gun that I already have? Like,
yeah, the hold down plus the PED suit where you shoot phase on it.
Oh, that?
Yeah.
That's like, like a power-up thing. I'm talking about like the regular gameplay against regular enemies in this game.
But that's what I'm saying. They want you to use that suit against the regular enemies.
Right, but that suit uses an energy tank every time you use it.
No.
I mean, it
you drop it, in it back. Right.
It costs health.
You have to be careful with it. Right. That's true.
And I think the pure combat in this game is good, and it's better than Metroid Prime 1 and 2, but although it tries to be a first-person shooter, it doesn't really succeed. Partially because the AI isn't there. Like, the average guy you're fighting, the average space pirate, really doesn't have much AI. And you don't really feel like you're fighting someone who's living and thinking. You just kind of stand there shooting the head a bunch.
That's sort of true, but they're better about dodging in this one. They also have armor sometimes where you have to blow off their armor with the missile.
They don't follow you. Like, I don't know.
But Metroid, like, combat is an aspect, but really most of it is exploration. Right. And it's like just, and on that respect, this game is definite improvement from 2, like huge, big time. There is still the backtracking, but it makes the backtracking feel like it's for a purpose. It feels like you're really, like, it feels like the scale is huge.
But I think much like Metroid Prime 2 Echoes, the level design is a little all over the place here. And, like, really high highs, some low lows. Like, you know, like one level I'll love, the next level I'll be like, I wish this was over.
I will say, you know, it's really hard to keep track of your map. Like, you have to use the map. And in some places, I'd zoom in on the map and I'm like, oh, God, I'm even zoomed all the way in. And it's hard to tell, like, how the hell I get through this.
Yeah, they didn't change the map at all. The map is the same as always been.
Right. But the rooms are clumped together and they're compact. And once you learn your way through it, you feel good, but there are some rooms that are better than others. So the scanning is back, and I started off scanning everything, and it's kind of one of those things where it's like, it's like a completionist thing. I do it, but kind of despite myself.
So much. I think there's more scanning.
Yeah.
I don't remember in Metroid Prime 1 and 2, like, individual doors, individual objects, being able to scan them before and after opening them with getting different readings. Like,
so one cool thing that they did, though, to make scanning worthwhile is you have these kind of achievements. I mean, it's not just scanning, but scanning, you earn achievements. If you do cool things, like if you kill enemies in a particular way. So you unlock these things, you get these achievements, and then you can use those to unlock, like, soundtrack songs, art galleries, and there's some cool, like, other options in there. And in the Wii Connect 24, you can even bequeath those, like, to your friends. Yeah, like your scrub friends. Right, the scripted events, which is something this game has done much more than the others, adds a lot to it, actually. And it's not just like, always like watch cutscene, then fight, then end cutscene. That stuff still happens, but it's much more things actually happen while you're doing it. Things fall apart, levels shift and change while you're running through them.
I feel like I've been kind of negative, but in reality, the game's real strong point is its level design. In the way that it's like a Zelda game. Like, really, this is Zelda in space. Like, more so than ever. Like, playing this one, it's like, these are dungeons. They are dungeon puzzles. There's a treasure in each dungeon. And with that, then I can do something, I can have a new mobility through this level. And then I fight a very Zelda-style boss. And there's lots of bosses like Metroid Prime 2, and they're all very good. And the
bosses are excellent, and I will say, like, the new combat makes fighting the bosses, like, it feels crazy, because you really build up this skill to be able to you have to keep relocking onto things, and you have to be aiming, and you have to be thinking missiles or which viewfinder, and you have to be thinking about hyper mode.
I still don't like missiles. Like, I don't like the placement. I have trouble doing that. I don't know what's wrong with my thumb, but, like, it's weird to me.
It doesn't feel more like a Zelda to me. It definitely feels like a Prime, and the way that it succeeded and it won me over, and it took me like 3 or 4 hours to start getting into it, and it's just getting better and better and better, and really, like, peaks, it climaxes where it should at the end, is the atmosphere. Right. Like, the feeling of being there, being able to be in an empty room, and maybe there's a puzzle, and the puzzles are quintessential Prime puzzles. They're not anything too tough. But, like, being in a room and just, like, wanting to look around and figure it out and explore and, like, look at every room is different. Every room is unique. Thank you. the feeling of being in this isolated world with the music and everything is really what's grabbed me.
I think we disagree there. Like, I think the graphics are okay. I think it's good for a Wii game, but like in terms of being evocative and making me feel like I'm really there, no, it doesn't. Like BioShock, like that makes me feel like I'm really there because the graphics look so good.
Right.
And this, like for me, the joy is the level design, the fighting the bosses. You know, that stuff's really cool. Like, I also love in this game that you get a lot of powers early on. Like in Metroid Prime 2, you didn't get a lot of the fun stuff until the very end. You didn't get a chance to use it. In this game, you get some of the better abilities early on, and they kind of assume you've already played Metroid Prime 1 and 2. I worry for people who are like new users who've never played Metroid Prime, they better play on easy, because this game,
it assumes
a lot of the player. That's it really
true.
Does.
That's very true. Yeah,
it's
like,
not an easy game.
I mean, I started off like this, I went down like this, and now I'm like, it made me a believer. Like, if it made me forget the Wii is piss poor graphically, which this game did. Right. Any game that can make me forget that I'm playing a game on the Wii, like on a glorified GameCube hardware, which this game has done, is unbelievable. Like, any game on a Wii that I can just sit there and like look in awe, like in actual awe at Wii graphics, it's completely art direction. This game is the best art directed game. I mean, those guys are complete masters.
But in the same game, there's cutscenes where they pull out and I'm like, this could be Star Fox 64.
Agreed.
Like, seriously.
Agreed. They should never show human faces ever. They should never show human faces, agreed. But man, when you're like, just the amount of detail and the I mean, these guys are geniuses in artwork. Like, they need to have Retro be doing a lot more stuff.
Yeah. All right.